Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Cadets Student Network's broadcast of CBC Basketball. We are coming to you live from the D.C. Willcutt Basketball Tournament, of course, in the D.C. Willcutt Gymnasium. Very special tournament. It's been a part of CBC Basketball for a long time. Extra special this year, certainly because we honor the memory of D.C. Willcutt, this being the first tournament since his passing towards the end of last semester. So certainly our thoughts and prayers with the Willcutt family. We know there's no better way to carry on the Willcutt legacy here at CBC than with some excellent basketball. We are excited to bring it to you here on the Cadet Student Network. My name is Tom Eichwald, and alongside me to bring you the game will be Coach Corey Bethany. Corey, nice to have you with us.
Nice to be here, Tom. How you doing?
I'm doing very well, thank you. Been a good season so far.
Yep.
Pretty good start to the tournament for the Cadets. We are here in the second round. CBC defeated Northwest Academy in the first round, 64-55. The opponent for the Cadets tonight, the Spartans of Hazelwood East, defeated North Tech 74-69. Any thoughts on the first round of this tournament?
It's a different look this tournament, I would say. Not the usual teams that we would have in here. Ledoux is one of the familiar teams that's in this tournament, but everyone else is pretty much new. Northwest, I think, is the first time here. Sodan is the first time here. Hazelwood East, is the first time here. I think Cardinal Ritter been here before, but a good look, good different view of talent, and, you know, it was a good first round on Monday.
And looking forward to this one. The Cadets coming into this with a record of 9-5 against the Spartans with a record of 10-4. First time they've met this season. And if you look at common opponents, there is only one common opponent these two teams have played. That would be Troy Buchanan. CBC defeated them on December 27th, 61-43. Hazelwood East played them a little earlier, November 30th, defeated them 69-67. A little closer game, but also very early in the season. We're going to throw to public address announcer Butch Dimovitz, and he will give you the opening prayer at starting lineups. We can't bring you the national anthem due to copyright laws, but we'll give you what we can give you, and then we'll be back to start this one here on CSN. I want to welcome you back to the booth here on CSN. There you have it, the starting lineups, the national anthem, the prayer. We are all set for DC Willcutt tournament action. Again, this is the second round, a berth to the finals against the winner of St. Louis Christian Academy and Cardinal Ritter is on the line between the cadets of CBC and the Spartans of Hazelwood East. And as we get ready for cadet basketball, we want to let you know tonight's tip is sponsored by State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo. Tim takes care of CBC, and he'll take care of you, too. So I want to thank Mr. Kylo for sponsoring tonight's tip. And as we get ready for this one, Corey, to bring you in here.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll do this right after the jump. As we get set here, it is Dwayne Clark against Amari Tate, and the cadets come down with it. Coming into this game, obviously the highlight for the Spartans, the scoring trio of Corey Shepard, James McKelvin, and Trevon Manley. Corey Shepard, the leading scorer on the team. What does CBC need to do coming in against a very feared trio such as that?
Well, they just need to play the game, and, you know, they thrive on their defense. So if you shut down, it seems like if you shut down Shepard, you'll be okay. There's an early foul here called on Orff, hand-checking foul.
So shut down Shepard and kind of let the – disperse.
Yes, let everyone else beat you. Like 21 points, averaging 21 points a game. You know, if you get that production down, you'll be just fine.
And as we see the Spartans trying to settle in here. Not the first time red-wearing Spartans have come into this gym. And that is Trevon Manley puts it in. So we have a tie game at 2:50 seconds into this one. Here is Orff at the other end. Yeah, and the start is for the cadets. Dwayne Clark in there, passes it inside to Kael Catchings. Also in there, Barnes, Orff, and Willis. And there's the shot and one from Trevon Manley. He gets his fourth of the night and a chance to make it five. Catching CBC a little bit on transition there.
And that's two early fouls on Sam Orff. You can almost expect them to pull him. Yeah, as Lee Richmond make his way to the table.
Especially, we mentioned the scorers that the Spartans have on the floor right now. Anytime you got scorers like that and you got somebody in foul trouble, you know they're going to go after you.
Yeah, absolutely.
You can't let them run away from you by not making contact, but you also can't foul out. And Orff puts that one away.
Nice take by Orff. Like he was bumped on the head on that one.
Here's Manley drives. A couple very large steps. That one rattles out, though. Catchings with the rebound. Good physical rebound. Willis from the corner. Looked good all the way, but rattles out. Orff to Barnes, and they're going to slow it down, settle in. Barnes up top. He's got Orff to his left. Dwayne Clark's going to check out, fake the pick. Orff inside to the big man. Back into Kael Catchings, and Catchings goes up for it.
Same play they did earlier and catch and missed layup. This time he dunks it to make sure he rallies it home.
Making no mistake. And here's Manley again. Speaking of making no mistake, Dwayne Clark wanted there to be no doubt about that block.
He got tired of Manley free will of going to the paint and finally protecting the basket. Good volleyball spike.
Yeah, it's no fun when you just have your hand up there, right? You got to take a swing. A move I know well from my basketball days, but usually on the wrong end of that. This is Darian McBride inbounding. Finds James McKelvin. McKelvin pulls up for the jumper, rattles off the rim.
That was contested again by Clark. Bad pass by Barnes. You don't see that often.
The alley-oop attempt.
And then failed to get back. Almost a easy layup.
All alone in the corner is Shepard. Good thing they couldn't find him. He had acres of space over here on the near side. And now Lee Richmond. Primarily defensive player, getting a few looks on the offensive end tonight. And Catchings goes in. Can't get that one to go.
Dwayne getting a good catch down low on the low block. I just want him to see, I want to like to see him turn towards the basket and finish strong. I think the Spartans is undersized as he gave that one away and here, shoot again.
Yeah, didn't have to pay the penalty, but good quick hands from James McKelvin. Stick out of hand, and that ball just stuck to it. There's the other number four, Barnes. In the corner for Richmond. Richmond goes underneath, lays it in. Good move from Lee.
Yeah, absolutely. Every point, every basket they made has been in the paint. It's been layups.
And now the Spartans at the other end. That was Darian McBride going up for it. And they're going to get Dwayne Clark for a block.
It's just too big to be taking blocks like that. Go in and contest the shot. You don't have any fouls. I'd rather you take the foul going for the block instead of trying to take a charge and getting called for the block.
And that will send McBride to the line. 8-4 game with 4:45 to go in the first. If you are just joining us, again, this is the second round of the D.C. Willcutt tournament. Both teams advancing with a win in the first round. We had the consolation second round just before this. Ledoux beat Soldan 69-61. So they advanced to the consolation final against Northwest. Now it's just the other side of the bracket that needs to be settled. And Willis.
No call on that?
Nope. A lot of contact, but they're saying play on.
Another hand checking.
Behind the head pass from Barnes, and we're going to get a foul on, looks like, McBride here. 25 for the Spartans.
That's what I don't understand. You call two quick ones on Sam. You know, the first time up
right.
The court, you call a little hand check, foul. Okay, you're going to call it tight, and then you allow that to happen.
You know, are you talking about the kind of Willis spill?
Yeah,
here?
The Willis spill, the hand check in towards with Jordan Barnes going to the hole. You know, just the inconsistency on that.
Well, hope to see that resolve itself as Josh Wallace gets another one from the line. That one goes in. Makes it 10-5.
CB still in a full court press, like a 2-2-1 press.
Got to say, except for a bobbled pass, the press was dealt with well by the Spartans. There, Catchings goes up for another one. There's a foul. McBride again, that's two quick ones on him. Again, you like the intensity from Cale Catchings. A player we've talked about a lot in our broadcast, mm-hmm. And don't mean to harp on this, but last year as a freshman showed so much talent, showed some physical ability, but as the time has gone by, especially going into this year, grown. You know,
yeah.
He's taller, but he's also filled out a little bit.
Yeah.
But he's grown mentally as well. He's taken charge of games. He's not one of those talented players around the periphery of a game. He wants to go right at you, which is, you know, when you got a sophomore who's already got that veteran mentality, that means a lot.
Absolutely. He's finishing a lot of layups that he was missing last year. He's finishing them with dunks.
Yeah, turning a few of them into dunks. And Barnes, speaking of finishing, puts that one away for three. 13-5. Barnes, first points of the night. And McBride in all kinds of space here.
Good D by Richmond there, getting back.
Yeah, very quick feet. Here's Willis. He's going to go, and he's going to draw a foul. This one is called on James McKelvin, but CBC doing a good job of getting to the basket. One of the things we've seen in some of the games where CBC struggled a little bit is getting stuck around the outside, being a little sluggish. They're getting after it right now, which is good to see.
Yeah, they beaten the Spartans back in transition.
3:45 to go here in this first quarter. 13-5 lead for the Cadets. Good start. Looks like Josh Nunn getting ready to check into this game. And McBride goes out for the Spartans. Into the game, number 45, Steve Shelton. And taking a breather right now is Cale Catchings. So here is Trayvon Manley. Good tip there from Willis.
Almost gave it away.
Almost did. Now here's Richmond. Willis.
One more. That's a force there. He had Dunn in the corner, spotted up for the three.
And Manley tries to force it across. Is that Wallace with the block?
That was Barnes.
Barnes.
Got his hands on it. Long rebound.
Willis one-on-one with Shepard. Puts it away. And CBC will take a timeout. So with 3:10 to go, it is 16-5 in favor of the Cadets. Well, we have a second. We want to ask you, Cadet fans, are you protected? Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim is more than just the best insurance guy in town. He's also the presenting sponsor of CSN, and we are incredibly grateful for his support. Call Tim at 314-842-4442 or send him an email, tim@timkylo, that's KILO.com. And as we break from the timeout, Corey, your thoughts on the opening 5 minutes or so from the Cadets?
A good pace for the Cadets. I mean, scoring 16, getting to the line six attempts. Can shoot better. They only shooting 50% from the line, but good pace, good defense. The Spartans having trouble with the full court press, and I expect Tatum to keep it on as expected. Look like man-to-man full court here by the Cadets.
Boy, this could not be more of a contrast with the last game we brought you here on CSN, at least the commentators, last game I did against Solias, where CBC got kind of stuck into a slow, very defensive game. Much more open here.
Good rebound there by Willis.
That was a rebound with authority. Here is Barnes. Willis wide open.
Two-man game, Willis and Barnes.
Miscommunication there between Shepard and Manley on who was sliding. And Christian Willis takes him for three. And we get a timeout going to the Spartans this time. We do want to let you know, we mentioned Tim Kylo helps us here at CSN. Also, CBC legend Larry Hughes. He has opened D1 Basketball Academy, a program that offers grade school boys and girls a chance to develop basketball skills on the court and leadership skills they will use for the rest of their lives. If your son or daughter loves to play, check out Larry Hughes' D1 Basketball Academy. Find him online at www.d1basketballstl.com. And as we get set to resume here, it will be James McKelvin inbounding for the Spartans. Again, the full court press from the Cadets. Dwayne Clark back as the center. Kelvin, good trap, but he finds Manley on the pass. That was Steve Shelton that went up for it over Dwayne Clark.
Wow.
And Shepard's head, looked like he got a piece of Cale Catching's knee or the other way around, but both appeared to be okay. That's good. 19-5 with 2:25 to go. Barnes. Pick from Dwayne Clark.
High pick and roll there. Catchings take it to the cup. No good, but good soft hands by Clark there.
Big man doing his job. Good start from Dwayne Clark.
I believe that's four or six.
Of course.
It's hard to see from here.
We've got the support for the hoop blocking the CBC points over there. We'll try to see how flexible we are and maybe bring you some reads at breaks.
I know it's two fouls on 50.
Yep.
May not know the points, but I know it's two. It's two fouls on him.
Yeah, he and Orff both have two for the Cadets, and McBride has two for the Spartans. And Shepard hits. Shepard is the leading scorer for the Spartans, averaging over 21 points a game, which is impressive, especially considering that right behind him, he's got James McKelvin with 17.5, Trevon Manley with 13.3. And Richmond, as we go out under 2 minutes, 21-7. And Josh Nunn's going to slow it down.
Oh, miscommunication between Nunn and Ketchins there.
A little too much. McKelvin with the interception.
Ooh.
Three for the number three, but it bounces out, and they're going to get a push against Cale Ketchings, a very confused Cale Ketchings.
He's calling it over the back. I didn't see it, you know, but he had a better angle than I do up here, you know, so.
That is usually the case.
Look clean from here, but, you know, obviously he has the better angle and the whistle, so.
Yes, that he does. And into the game now for Hazelwood East, number 11, Dejon Walls. Rebound from Ketchings. Ooh, behind the back. Nice move.
Fancy.
Welcome to the game, Dejon Walls. That one goes out. It'll be CBC ball. A minute 14 to go, 21-7. You got a 14, you got a 21, you got a 7. You got lots of multiples of 7 up there. Inbounding the ball, 22, not a multiple of 7. This is Lee Richmond. Wallace up top. Can't find him, but Ketchings goes for it, and that's out of bounds off of Shepard, it appears. Nope, they're going to say it went off Ketchings last. So this will be Spartan ball with 1:12 to go as Willis checks in for Josh Nunn.
Tough inbound pass there by Lee Richmond.
Yeah, the movement that there was, the only real option he had in space was way at the top, which wasn't all that appealing, to be honest with you. In the corner, it's McKelvin, and he puts it away for two.
Tough shot there.
So it's 21-9 as we go below a minute here. Willis bringing it up for the Cadets. Orff and Clark of the starters taking a break. Davis Oftenbrink in there. And they're going to get Willis on a travel.
That's a force. I mean, that is a... That's a force. That's all. I mean, that's the nicest way I can put it. We didn't need it at that point. The pick and pop didn't work in. The inside game, you got two bigs in there with Ketchings and Wallace.
McKelvin for three from the corner. Gets that one to go.
And the Spartans are heating up.
Yep, James McKelvin starting to warm up with those outside shots. And here is Willis, 21 seconds to go. Good steal from Walls. They're going to say went out of bounds. And it will be Cadets ball going in. Barnes checks back in for Richmond. He's coming in for the last offensive set here. And Ketchings will inbound it to him. Inside of 20 seconds. You can hear Coach Tatum from here saying one shot. They're going to hold it as we go to 10 seconds. Barnes into the corner. Finds Oftenbrink, who does a nice job to keep it in bounds. Barnes back in the corner. 3 seconds, he gets it up.
Short.
And that one's no good, and the Spartans aren't going to get a go at it. And that is going to do it for the first quarter. After a quarter of action here, it is 21-12 in favor of the Cadets. Folks, we want to ask you, have you visited our friends at Kenrick's Meats and Catering? Stop in for steaks, roasts, burgers, brats, delicious deli trays. The folks at Kenrick's have it all. Check them out in South County and Weber Road. Joe the Butcher and his crew are always slicing up something special. You can learn more online, www.kenricks.com, or give them a call at 314-631-2440, and go see our friends at Kenrick's. Now, Coach Corey, we talked a little bit about the things that CBC was doing right in the first quarter. We talked about the speed they're playing at. They're hitting their shots. They're getting aggressive. They're going for the rebounds. As far as Hazelwood East is concerned, certainly not an untalented group. You certainly wouldn't pass a put a comeback past them at this point. What can they do to get back in this game?
Well, I mean, they have to rebound a little better and play better defense. They kind of outmatch in the paint, so they had to prevent and deny the ball from going into the paint. And I don't know. I see with this size, with their size, their athleticism, they should be able to beat CBC in that up and down on the court. So maybe they can get in a fast-paced game. It's going to be a foul on five as he had catches. He had an elbow up the catch's deck.
That is Trayvon Manley. That's not allowed. Catching's inbounds to Barnes. And we are in the second quarter here. And again, the second round of the D.C. Willcutt tournament. A berth in the finals at stake.
That's the pick and pop play, play I was speaking of earlier. And
didn't work out.
Well, Wallace didn't roll to the basket. He kind of faded away and Barnes was expecting him to go towards the basket.
And there's a rebound for the Spartans and a good lay-in. Finger roll from Steve Shelton. Nice rebound from Shelton. And that brings him within 7 points. And we see Willis. Catchings. Barnes. A bit of a sloppy pass. Couldn't get the shot off. And again, quick feet, good defense from the Spartans. Willis rolls,
there
kicks it
go.
Out to Oftenbrink. Oftenbrink gets a shot up. No good, but he is fouled. No.
He's going to call a foul on Wallace there.
That's Wallace. So first foul for Josh Wallace. And it will be Spartan ball inbounded by Walls. And CBC persisting with the press. As the Spartans try to get back into this one, still trailing by 7. Walls goes it himself.
Good block by Wallace.
Very good block. Another authoritative one. Now Barnes for 3. Doesn't go. And again, the rebound from Steve Shelton, who's going to break the other way. He's got McKelvin alongside of him to help.
Oh, blocked. I think Wallace got a piece of that one, too.
He might have.
Way to run the floor, freshman.
Yeah, good work from Wallace, but also Steve Shelton. 2 consecutive rebounds and 2 consecutive breaks. Solo efforts, really. Here's Shepard from the corner. And Lee Richmond knocks him down, but they're going to get Willis inside for a foul on McKelvin, it appears. Bit of a push underneath or something.
That's a lot of fouls from the loose ball fouls from, you know, off the ball.
Definitely.
And for the rebound, that will put the Spartans in a one-on-one situation.
And this free throw being taken with 6:46 to go in the first half. McKelvin hits, and they're going to give him another one. First one went well enough. And we're having the referees talking to Josh Wallace and looks like Shepard down here. And they're going to have Willis trade places. They're just checking on each other's day.
That was smart by Willis. Try to defuse the situation and ask Wallace to switch. Say, hey, I got this over here.
Veteran leadership. And something's being sorted out over at the scorer's table.
Oh, they gave the foul. They had the foul up to number 1. Oh, I'm sorry, number 4 for
James
the
McKelvin.
Spartans, and it was for Willis. So they correct the foul on the scoreboard.
Well, that has been sorted out, and we continue. Willis pulls up for the jumper, hits it. Talk about leadership, a little smart play down here to get Wallace out of a bad situation. Goes right down the other end, puts a basket in. That is his 8th of the night. 8th point, that is, not 8th basket. McKelvin goes up for it. Can't get it to go. CBC swarms the rebound. Richmond decides to go for it. Checks it back for Josh Nunn. He's going to get a shot here. Up and over McKelvin, but it doesn't go. Boy, McKelvin's got some long arms, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
He could be 18 feet away from you, and he's right there when he jumps. It's impressive. Willis with a good rebound. 23-16 with 5:47 to go. Willis is going to go for it.
Left, no good.
And again, McKelvin there put just enough pressure on him for him to miss it. And here's Shelton at the other end. Good hustle from Josh Nunn, though. The pace in this game is impressive.
Yeah, they picked it up a little bit.
It's Barnes, one-on-one with Walls.
Nice. That is very nice. You don't see that much from high schoolers there. The stop and pop, that is a lost art. That's going to be
Walls was still moving backward when the shot was released. The ball was out of his hands, and Walls was still moving, thinking he was dribbling.
Yeah.
That's how fast that was.
Be able to stop on a dime and get a shot off, elevate it. You know, he gets up there for a little guy.
He does.
That's why he's going to a D1 college to play basketball.
Well, we've talked before about just his ability to, you know, his legs are moving a mile a minute, and his hands stay so soft and in control. It's really impressive.
Yeah. I mean, he's putting on a display here.
He is. Why not?
But, yeah.
That was a little short, but
he was feeling it. He was feeling it.
I think we should let him take those shots. Here is Manley at the other end. Finds Walls. Shepard. Quick movement from the Spartans.
Good rotation by the Cadets. Almost a turnover there. Yeah. Air ball there.
Shepard puts it back. He'll call it a pass. And there's the inbound. Here's Barnes bringing it up. 4.5 to go. There's another stop.
Good find by Dunn.
Nunn in the corner. That one goes. It's a 28-18. Walls finds Manley in the corner.
Manley with his best Jordan Barnes impression. Personation.
He beat Christian Willis there. I don't know if you noticed this, but Christian Willis didn't look back at him. He got beat, said, well, there's the shot. Nothing I can do about that. I'm just going to pretend that didn't happen. And goes the other end. That's how you make up for it.
Oh. Kristen almost got teed up on that one. I think this ref's going right to him. Watch him.
Well, what's funny is he turned around to shout something in excitement, and that's exactly where the ref was. You kind of see him turn and shout and then stop it and walk away.
He shouted and won, meaning he got fouled. And that ref is almost, if he was reaching for a flag, he thought he maybe was reffing football. He's reaching for his football.
Yeah, the whistle hand flinched. I think it moved up a touch. And we get a timeout here. Well, we have a second. Cadet fans, you know a grade school student who might be a future cadet. Please encourage him to pay us a visit and experience CBC for himself. Contact our admissions office at 314-985-6095 to schedule a tour of CBC or a shadow visit. Don't forget that 7th grade shadowing is now available. Just call Melissa Ryan at 314-985-6095. Spend a day with us and experience what CBC is all about. And with 3 minutes and 42 seconds to go in this half, CBC would like to thank all of the teams competing this week as we honor D.C. Willcutt, a legendary CBC coach, educator, and administrator. Coach Willcutt passed away this past October, but his legacy lives on here at CBC. Together with his wife, Vivian, the Willcutts have committed so much of their lives to our school. We are forever, forever grateful for their support, and we thank all of you who have tuned in to support the cadets here at the 2016 D.C. Willcutt Tournament. Few have given as much to CBC as the Willcutt family. Years, dedication, passion. And up until the very end, D.C. Willcutt loved coming to this tournament, so we're happy to have this in honor of a truly great cadet. And here is Manley going for another one from the line. Lead was starting to get away from him a little bit there, but the Spartans have done a nice job of they're still scrapping, and they are now within 8 of the Cadets, a game that you felt was going somewhere else for a while. Barnes talking to Willis, telling him to switch, move inside. Here's Josh Nunn. Pick from Willis. This time it's Barnes inside to Ketchings. Ketchings one-on-one.
In and out.
Yep. He was one-on-one with Darian McBride. Beat him, just couldn't beat the rim. And they're going to get something being sorted out over there, and it'll be Spartan ball. Cadets again with the press. 3:15 to go here in the second quarter. It's Ari Jackson checking in for the Cadets.
It's the first time I seen him in action.
He played a little bit against in the Helias game. Got a couple minutes here and there. Brings a great intensity to the game.
He was dunking that the whole time.
Speaking of which.
Well, that's Catchings there. He was, you saw it in his eye. Like, he was dunking that the whole way. There's something that we got away from, the points inside. I think we can get that anytime we want.
And just looking around the gym, you see a couple of college logos on pullovers and various things, a couple notebooks in the crowd. Got to imagine that those holding them are writing down the number 24.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. Oh.
Talk about some of the sophomore athletes right now. I mean, who comes to mind better? Who is better right now in any sport as a sophomore? Then, you know, you got Cale Catchings in basketball.
Yeah.
You got Cameron Babb in football.
Yeah.
It's inspiring.
That sophomore class is something special. You know, not just here at CBC, but all around the St. Louis area. Some really good, the Cartier Gordon kid at Vianney, you know, he's a sophomore. You know, you just got phenomenal players in that.
It'll make it exciting for us here on CSN, and we hope for you at home as well. Now, of course, we talk about the athletics. A lot more than athletics going on here. For all you music fans, don't miss Club CBC on Saturday, January 16th, coming up soon. Join us in Ross Hall for a night of fun to support the CBC Music Program. Our award-winning jazz band, studio band, and percussion ensemble will be joined by members of our choir for an incredible show. See Mr. Sharkey if you're a student or any member of the music program to get your tickets today. Information, I believe, can also be found on the website. So check it out. Also, speaking of website, new exciting development academically, the CBC course guide now available in interactive form on the website. As Barnes puts one away, you can see all the courses offered here at CBC from the CBC website in a new format. But in the meantime, back to basketball. Barnes is at the line with 1:57 to go here in the first half, 34-25 in favor of the Cadets.
Good drive and layup there by Barnes, putting the Cadets up by 10.
And the ball in the corner from Manley. Manley beats Jackson, and Richmond puts it away. Or beats Richmond as well and puts it away. Richmond didn't. Be clear. 1:35 to go. Barnes, one-on-one with Shepard. Catchings inside. Turns.
It's going to be a one-on-one bonus. Catchings going to the line. They can't control. They have no answer for the low post entry.
And that's the second foul on Trevon Manley. And first one no good from Catchings. Gets his own rebound, though.
Oh, that's a double dribble.
They didn't see it. And I will say, that's more exciting than watching him make the second free throw. I will point that out. I'm not sure Coach Tatum will see it that way, but as fans, we can do that. Rebound from Barnes as the pace in this game continues to be enthralling.
Good steal there by Dunn.
Nunn in the corner. Barnes, 58 seconds now, inside of a minute. Josh Nunn. Got Ari Jackson to help him. Nunn goes for it himself. Can't quite convert, and Hazelwood East at the other end, putting it away. That was William Gilliard laying it in for his first points of the night. 40 seconds now. Clock ticking down. The Cadets with an 8-point lead. Josh Nunn. Now Cale Catchings. Catchings had a very, very good half. Barnes not doing too shabby either. That one goes. That wasn't even close to any of the rim.
Man, that was pretty. Used the pick of the big body Cale Catchings and knocked it down.
And Shepard can't get it to go on the other end. Manley plays it off of, tries to play it off of Richmond, but it's going to be CBC ball with 8.7 seconds to go. The intensity from the CBC bench in the last few seconds here has been impressive. They do not want to let Hazelwood East get anything at the end of this half.
Definitely want to go in halftime with a double-digit lead.
Makes halftime a lot more pleasant. And a little bit of confusion for CBC right now. They get it sorted out as Wallace checks in. A little confusion on the substitution there. Some chuckles over on the bench. You can do that when you're winning. Here's Barnes. Behind the back, 5 seconds.
Oh, he pushed off. I didn't see it, though.
Yeah, very slight. The coaching staff at Hazelwood East did see it.
Well, they had the better angle at it.
They did. That one we might have had the best angle.
Yes, we did. We did.
That's going to do it for the first half here, the second round of the first half of the first game of the second round of the D.C. Willcutt Tournament. The score at halftime is 40-29. We are going to take a break here on CSN, let you hear from some of our sponsors. When we come back, we will have second half action for you right here from the Tim Kylo broadcast booth. Stick around. You won't want to miss it.
Let me help you protect what matters most and prepare for your retirement. I want to help everyone in the CBC family save money and stay protected. I've been in the business for 25 years. My team and I are ready to help you protect your family and save money. You can contact me at 314-842-4442. My email address is tim@timkylo.com. And my website is timkylo.com. Enjoy the rest of the game. Let me help you protect what matters most and prepare for your retirement. I want to help everyone in the CBC family save money and stay protected. I've been in the business for 25 years. My team and I are ready to help you protect your family and save money. You can contact me at 314-842-4442. My email address is tim@timkylo.com, and my website is timkylo.com. Enjoy the rest of the game.
Henrik Meats and Catering is so much more than just St. Louis's best butcher shop. Visit them in South County at 4324 Weber Road to dine at the K Cafe, or give them a call to cater your next party.
Joe the Butcher and the team at Kenrick's cater everything from corporate parties to family barbecues. Let them cook for you and your friends too.
Formal sit-down meals, premium buffets, barbecues, and box lunches, they do it all at Kenrick's, and always at the best prices. The state champion football team at CBC loves sitting down to a Kenrick's meal, and so will your guests. Take the pressure out of your next party and let the team at Kenrick's take care of you. Give them a call at 314-631-2440 or visit them online at kenricks.com for more details on all that is offered at Kenrick's Meats and Catering. Kenrick's, we're your party people.
Come see us at Kenrick's.
Kenrick's Meats and Catering is so much more than just St. Louis's best butcher shop. Visit them in South County at 4324 Weber Road to dine at the K Cafe, or give them a call to cater your next party.
Joe the Butcher and the team at Kenrick's cater everything from corporate parties to family barbecues. Let them cook for you and your friends too.
Formal sit-down meals, premium buffets, barbecues, and box lunches, they do it all at Kenrick's, and always at the best prices. The state champion football team at CBC loves sitting down to a Kenrick's meal, and so will your guests. Take the pressure out of your next party and let the team at Kenrick's take care of you. Give them a call at 314-631-2440 or visit them online at kenricks.com for more details on all that is offered at Kenrick's Meats and Catering. Kenrick's, we're your party people.
Come see us at Kenrick's.
Welcome back to the booth here on CSN. We are all set for the second half of CBC versus Hazelwood East. This is the second round of the DC Willcutt tournament. Both of these teams won in their first game. So the winner of this game will advance to play the winner of Cardinal Ritter and St. Louis Christian Academy in the final, the championship game on Friday night right here in the DC Willcutt Gymnasium. Tom Eichwald bringing you the game alongside Corey Bethany here on the Cadet Student Network. And your thoughts on the first half, Corey?
Very, very, very good basketball for the CBC Cadets. You know, scoring 40 and having complete control of the whole game. Early foul troubles by Orff, as you see him back in the lineup, about to inbound the ball. But and also Dwayne Clark. But look to see these two guys get it going here early in the second half.
And here is Barnes. Inside for Cale Catchings. Say Catchings and Willis.
That's too easy.
That is way too easy.
They can't defend that. You know, it was going for the alley-oop pass to Clark, but he got held up a little bit, but he still was able to catch it over the head and get the rebound. With the easy layup.
And again, Dwayne Clark grabbing the rebound, but just starting to say, Catchings and Willis, the two players who probably, Barnes has done some phenomenal things in this game, but the intensity of the game has been provided by Willis and Catchings. It's been fun to watch them really get after these Spartans.
There's another inside layup.
Draws the foul. They're going to get McKelvin on the, oh no, correction. That is number 30, Omari Tate, his second foul. And Dwayne goes to the line to shoot two. And first one good. We hope you're enjoying the broadcast. Of course, we call the game. I know what end of the microphone to speak in, but this is all made possible by the students we have working the broadcast. William Kratz, Charlie Hines. I think those are the only two we have tonight, but they're working and they're doing a great job tonight. John Rolfe, he's been around as well. Don't want to leave him out. I think he made a concession stand run, but he is working with us tonight. Mr. Randy Gardner, as always, our fearless leader here on CSN. So I want to thank all the boys on CSN for all the work they do to bring you broadcasts of CBC events as we see Shepard put that one away. 43-31 with 7 to go. Now, you talked at the beginning of the game, Corey, about the need to really shut down Corey Shepard. Has CBC managed to do that?
Yes, I believe so. I mean, he had a nice move there up and under. But absolutely, he hasn't made his open shots, but here's one here he may take. See, good close out there. They're just making it tough on Shepard.
Now, before we came back on halftime, I don't think you could see this out of the corner of the monitor, but the Spartans very keen on getting Shepard going. He was on the outside looking at three-pointers, and they were just feeding him ball after ball after ball. And I got to say, he hit at least 80% of them. So trying to get him going. Here's McKelvin. Doesn't go, and Dwayne Clark again with the rebound. Sam Orff. Barnes in the corner. Can't get it to go, and easy rebound eventually for Omari Tate. As Shepard breaks on the other end. Welcome to the lane, says Dwayne Clark.
Ugh. It's going to go against Catchings.
They're going to get him on the block there. That is his second foul, if I am not mistaken.
That is correct.
And here is Manley at the line. First one goes, 5:45 lead, 15, which is about as big as it's been all night. But apart from the first maybe 5-6 minutes of this game, you've never gotten the feeling that anybody was going to run away with this. Hazelwood East, certainly you know the kind of talent they have, but they have been getting after CBC. They've managed to cut the lead down several times. Get the feeling they just need one swing of momentum to kind of really make this a game again. Willis gets fouled. That foul on James McKelvin.
He had a clean up top. I thought maybe the ref called it a little body down low as Christian hit his first one.
And going for the second is Willis. One of the things we've seen the cadets struggle with off and on this year is the free throw shooting.
Yeah, absolutely. They're struggling in this game as well.
Yeah, how are we doing tonight? I see you keeping stats over there, Coach Bethany. Shepard hits that one.
We're 7 for 12.
7 for 12. Better than 50%. Man. Not much, though. Here's McKelvin. Catchings with the rebound, finds Barnes. And here is Jordan Barnes. Finds Willis inside for Catchings, puts that one up and in. And just like that.
I think that's...
They're on a mission to keep us from seeing the point totals. But Catchings having himself a very good game. That we can say with certainty. And this will be Spartan ball underneath the basket. This is Shepard. Up top, finds Tate. Around to McBride. McBride's going to take the shot, puts it away. Again, the lead now 14. As cadets get the ball. Cadet fans, are you protected? Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim is more than just the best insurance guy in town. He's also the presenting sponsor of CSN, and we are incredibly grateful for his support. Call Tim at 314-842-4442 or send him an email at tim@timkylo.com. That's K-I-L-O.com. And that one's going to go the way of the Spartans. McBride. Shepard spins inside, goes for the shot, can't get it to go.
He just can't get in. He can't hit anything right now.
Summary of the night for him. You see a little frustrated clap of the hands.
Good take there by Sam. And he slips.
There's some moisture on the floor. Did he slip on a pom-pom?
No, he slipped on a pom-pom.
Yeah, his foot went out from under him. Certainly hope he is okay. Trainer's going to get out there and take a look as the cheerleaders kick their pom-poms back against the wall. Got to imagine it's happened before, but can't say I've seen it.
I think it should have been in their hands, not on along the baseline. But, hey, maybe they learned their lesson.
Yeah, they're all kind of putting them back now.
Just tucking them up.
Certainly hope Sam is okay.
That's probably hard to...
That's not one you want to explain at school tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly.
Slipped on a pom-pom. Okay, so he's smiling over there. He appears to be okay.
Yeah. I think I know what happened, but just hope that he's okay.
And here is Manley. Finds McKinley. Or McKelvey. McKelvin.
McKelvin.
How many times have I said that name tonight? Now I can't get it.
Shepard missed again from short range.
Yep, Willis like going the other way. Sorry to cut you off there. That one's tipped, and it's going the way of the Spartans. 3:38 to go in the third quarter. Cadets still with a fairly comfortable lead, but it doesn't take much to make it uncomfortable.
It's another turnover by Barnes. That's the last two trips down.
And Sam Orff is up, moving around.
Good help D there by Willis.
Yep, and he gets the ball on it, too. Leaves it for Barnes, and Barnes is going to set it up. He's got Catchings up top. Willis in the corner, inside to Catchings. Boy, that's some of the quickest ball movement you're going to see at the high school
level. Yeah, absolutely.
Again, we talked about things we often criticize them for. Free throw shooting, a little bit of an issue tonight. But, you know, getting stuck around the outside of games and moving the ball a little bit slow at times. Haven't seen that tonight. CBC right now are a team very much playing in a gear that not many teams are capable of.
Well, they're playing their game, and they're forcing a wheel on the Spartans.
And as CBC brings in Wallace and Young, or Nunn, rather.
Last foul was called on Tate. Tate with his third.
It is a moment of note. And it's timeout called by the Cadets. While we have a timeout, we mentioned a couple of young players coming on. If you've got a young player at home, CBC legend Larry Hughes has opened D1 Basketball Academy. This is a program that offers grade school boys and girls a chance to develop basketball skills on the court and leadership skills they will use for the rest of their lives. If your son or daughter loves to play, check out the Larry Hughes D1 Basketball Academy. Find them online at d1basketballstl.com. And we got basketball. The only thing missing is some quality food. So, if you want quality food, you should go see our friends at Kenrick's Meats and Catering. Stop in for steaks, roasts, burgers, brats, delicious deli trays. The folks at Kenrick's have it all. Check them out in South County on Weber Road, and Joe the Butcher and his crew will be willing to slice you up something special. Learn more online, www.kenricks.com, or give them a call at 314-631-2440, and go see our friends at Kenrick's. Willis for Clark.
That's all day.
Way too easy.
I don't have a post presence, and, you know, just throw it up high, let the big man catch it and finish.
Yeah. When they figure out how to stop it, try something else.
Yep. Ooh, almost blocked there. Nice shot. Tough shot there by McKelvin.
Went for the volleyball spike again. Impressive from McKelvin.
Just them long arms.
You know, as Willis drives, with the game and, you know, the kind of build, reminds me a little bit of a CBC blast from a few years ago, Pat McCaw.
Yeah, absolutely.
Reminds me a lot of Pat McCaw.
He's playing at UNLV right now, having a pretty good season. Good dribbling display there by Willis. Find Dunn in the left. Off rim.
Doesn't go. Could be the hair, too. Very similar haircut.
Clark is trying to swat everything and swatted the nets on top of the rim.
And going to the line is number 25, Darian McBride. 2:11 to go in this one. 55-39 in favor of the Cadets. And that one doesn't go. We're going to get a couple substitutions. Orff checking back into the game. He's going to come in and give Christian Willis a break. DeJohn Walls coming in for the Spartans. And Shepard taking a break to get some instructions over there on the bench. Got the feeling he's not going to be out long. McBride good on the second one. Lee Richmond will inbound. Richmond, Nunn, Orff, Wallace, and Dwayne Clark right now. Two seniors, a junior, two freshmen. It's not just the present everybody's excited about here at CBC.
Nice spin move. Jump shot there by Orr.
Under 2 minutes now, 1:45 to go to be exact. Manley cuts into the lane.
Rebound out. Lee up to Wayne, too easy.
Yep. Timed it perfectly, drew the foul.
All he had to do was catch it. Love to see the big man run up the court that way.
I love to see it as long as he's not running at me. Because I'm safely up here. So with a minute and a half to go in this third quarter. Dwayne Clark at the line. And that's going to help the cause. And CBC having a good time over there. Orff having a laugh with the bench. With Barnes over there. Right in the middle of it. Surprise. Orff and Barnes, two of the nicer young men you will find anywhere. And Richmond gets beat around the side. And McKelvin can't get it to go. Richmond again. Now Josh Nunn. Orff.
Looking inside.
Yeah, miscommunication with Dwayne. But the bigger story, Orff appears to be moving okay. And just a few minutes ago, slipped on a pom-pom. Now here is McKelvin.
CBC in their traditional 2-3 zone. Good help defense there. Good rotation.
And organization. They all collapsed, you know, kind of in the paint there. But then what you saw was when they all exploded outward, they all exploded to the right spot. So what looked chaotic on the collapse was actually very, very well organized. That is some discipline right there. That's a well-drilled team. 30 seconds now here in this third quarter. Down low, bouncing around. McBride breaks with it. He's going to have to beat Wallace, and he draws the foul. Clock is stopped with 16.2 to go. And we're going to have two shots here for McBride. Josh Wallace's second foul. So an 18-point lead for the Cadets. Darian McBride trying to make it a little bit smaller for the end of the quarter. Now, folks, if you're a fan of CSN, you've definitely heard us mention our friend State Farm agent Tim Kylo. Tim is a CBC grad, and he takes care of us here at the Cadet Student Network. This fall, we are going to say thanks to Tim. Actually, this winter now. We're going to say thanks to Tim on Twitter. Find Tim on Twitter by searching @riskagent and then give him a follow. It's @riskagent. Join us all year, not just fall or winter, as we thank Tim on Twitter. And here's Nunn. Moving the ball well. Finds Orff in the corner. Off the rim. And the Spartans can't break for one more. So we will enter the fourth quarter with the Cadets 16 points clear. We kind of said this earlier, but CSN is about more than just athletics. Our fine and performing arts program delivered some of the fantastic Christmas concerts. The recent performances, Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. Got the Adams Family coming up from the drama department. You can visit cbccsn.com anytime to see all the great things happening here at CBC. From the classroom to the court, from the field to the stage, if it's happening at CBC, you will find it on CSN. Now, Corey, as we go into this fourth quarter here, the Cadets keep doing what you're doing. I think that's anybody can coach this fourth quarter, at least from that perspective. But for Hazelwood East, a little trickier situation. You're down by 16. Stranger things have happened.
Yep.
What's going on in the team meeting right there?
They got to get shots up now. I mean, you're down 16 points, so you got to score. You got to score quick. So any open shot you get, fire away. And turn up the intensity on defense. Hopefully you force turnovers by the Cadets.
8 minutes separating CBC from the final of the D.C. Willcutt tournament. Here is Manley. And a good move inside by McBride, but you got to make it. Dwayne Clark doing a nice job of rebounding.
Good presence, too. He altered that shot.
Good rebounding quarter can kill this game in a hurry.
They pretty much, they doubling Clark there, and Lee try to force it. That's a turnover there by the Cadets, and Spartans turning into 2 points.
And this is going to be a foul on Trayvon Manley. That is his third foul. Christian Willis is going to check in for Lee Richmond. And Dwayne Clark is going to get a breather. Ari Jackson on. So with 7:16 to go now, here is Josh Nunn. We do want to let you know we are planning, especially if CBC makes it, we are planning on doing the final on Friday. So should CBC hold on, that will be Friday at 8 p.m. right here in the D.C. Willcutt Gymnasium. Friday at 8 p.m., if CBC wins, they would play the winner of St. Louis Christian Academy and Cardinal Ritter, who are playing right after this, for the D.C. Willcutt Championship.
You seen any of those two teams play?
I have not.
Neither have I.
I have not. We'll be sure to do our scouting prior to that broadcast.
Well, I saw him walk in the building, and that St. Louis Christian team, man, they had some size on them.
That's the extent of what we know. That's why we'll take a look on these broadcasts. It's always fun to get the stats reports going into a broadcast with records and scoring statistics, defensive statistics, minutes played. It's always fun to kind of get to know a team in a very short period of time. So look forward to seeing that. But, of course, you got to tie up ends here. So 14-point lead.
Oh.
And they're going to get a double dribble, looks like, on Orff. So it will be Spartans ball. Don't need to be double dribbling with a 14-point lead. And Shelton puts that one away. And Steve Shelton.
Creating turnovers and hitting open shots. Oh, push off there.
That time they did get the push off.
Good sale job.
Well
too,
sold, I was going to say. Very well sold by Dijon Walls. He gets a high five from Shepard over there. But I've been wondering, we've had a few cases of CBC pushing off that haven't been called. I was wondering if the coaching staff of Hazelwood East was going to say, start selling, boys. And
well, I mean,
they did.
He's been asking for it the whole time, usually on Barnes.
Well, Barnes has been doing it. Yeah. Orff has gotten away with a couple.
Another turnover, another 2 points, and it's a 10-point game. Just that quick.
And here's Barnes. He's got Willis up top. Uses him. Jump shot from Christian Willis. Rattles out. East almost put it in. And Wallace puts it away and draws the foul.
I love how that young man battled on those boards. He's in there for one job. Let's get rebounds. Tonight he has, I think he has 4 points. With two more, you know, to gain on the line. And they have him for six.
And he's also a freshman.
Yeah.
He is a freshman. Manley. Wallace closes down. Oh, and they're going to get Willis on a reach. Willis does not agree. And McBride will get to shoot two.
Not only did they call the foul, they say he was going up for a shot. I thought it was a one-on-one situation.
I think Willis would disagree with both of those things.
Yeah.
Here's McBride. A little short. He's going to go back, redo his calculations. And McBride for a second one. This to get within 11. Also a little short, but gets the benefit of the rim. And the backboard, and then the rim again. Getting his money's worth. Here is Barnes. Behind the back again, underneath. That was such a good pass, it even faked out the guy it was going to.
Yeah, freshman wasn't ready for it.
And Shelton's shot, rebounded by Dwayne Clark. Dwayne doing a great job down low. Can't say they've really had a solution for him. And here is Wallace. None. Freshman, freshman, senior, senior with the passes. A full house out there with the three seniors and the two freshmen. Under 5 minutes to go now. 4:50. 11-point game. Willis trying to make it a 13-point game. And the number 13 makes it a 13-point game, and he's going to get to go to the line. Hopefully he puts this one away, and the numerical coincidence doesn't last very long. And Shepard checks back in for the Spartans. Nice long break for him. Longer than I thought they'd give him.
Yeah.
But you know what that means. Well, you got 4:47 to go. Better go hard after a long break.
Well, they caught a good little rhythm, so almost they didn't want to interrupt that. So, see, that's why they was on the bench that long.
And here's Walsh. Good speed. Goes up over Dwayne Clark, which is hard to do.
High kiss off the glass.
Beautiful touch. Walls did not start this game, but he's looked good. Barnes, yeah, the cell didn't work there. There wasn't much contact, I don't think. And Walls goes in, doesn't get it to go. There was some contact in there. And now Barnes at the other end. Thought that was blocked, and he puts it in.
He puts it in.
And just like that, back to a 13-point lead. Barnes picks up his 13th of the night. Manley into the corner. Shepard. Walls. Good pick for McBride. Into the corner for McKelvin. Can't get it to go.
Walls is exhausted. Can't even get back down the court.
Boy, he's been impressive with the pace he's put on.
Yeah.
Can't do that forever, though.
You got a mismatch here with the freshman.
I was going to say, he's got Wallace. And Wallace, a good 6 inches taller at least.
Yeah. And he's exhausted.
You got a tired 5'11 going up against an energized 6'5. That was a pretty good eyeball, actually. 6 inches?
Yeah.
Right there. 3:19 and 13 points, the difference right now. CBC looking to make it to the finals yet again. And first one goes from Nunn. It's a high five from Barnes. Barnes, Nunn, Willis, Wallace, and Clark in right now. Clark at the other end of the court carrying on some small talk with Jason Tatum. Some of the Chaminade players here to take this one in. And Spartans put that one away.
It's a good shot over the outreach arms of Clark there. Wallace got to catch those.
Yep. That's twice now. He's been caught off guard, first by the quickness of Barnes and now by the quickness of Willis.
I think he saw that one. He just didn't catch it.
And he's going to get a break so he can think about it.
His dad over there showing him how to catch the ball. He's probably been doing that his whole 14 years of living.
Is that every father's advice? If it hits both hands, you can catch it?
Yep.
Barnes, 2:38 to go.
Oh,
Alex.
Wow.
No commentary needed.
And Clark looks there at Tatum, Jason Tatum. And Tatum's like, yeah, I caught plenty of those from Jordan Barnes as well. So
that was cool. 2:25 to go. We get a timeout. Spartans over there swapping memories of the alley-oop, but also trying to figure out if there's any way to claw themselves back into a 15-point deficit. And with 2:25 to go, CBC feeling good for the time being at least. In case you didn't hear it the first time and the second time, CBC legend Larry Hughes has opened D1 Basketball Academy. If you want to learn how to catch alley-oops like that, I'm sure Larry Hughes can teach you. It is a program that offers grade school boys and girls a chance to develop basketball skills on the court and, more importantly, leadership skills that they will use for the rest of their lives. If your son or daughter loves to play, check out Larry Hughes' D1 Basketball Academy. Find them online at d1basketballstl.com. Looking down into the corner here of this one, talk about D.C. Willcutt, the great name and the great contributions that he made to CBC as Shepard puts that one in. Looking down at Ray Barr and Brian Haggerty over there. Mr. Rich Judd also here. Another group of men who have given a lot to this school. A lot of graduates like myself, very grateful to those men. Mr. Haggerty, one of my favorite teachers while I was here, and Mr. Barr kept us, protected us from ourselves.
He was the dean, right?
Student he
dean?
Was the, not the dean of students, the dean of men. Dean of men.
I stand corrected.
Yes. You would have been corrected if you had said that as well. Two great men. Coach Haggerty probably talking wrestling with Tony Cassiolic.
Well, I don't know. Coach Pingle's over there.
Yeah, Coach Pingle's over
so
there. Maybe
you know
a little bit of
football.
Until TK mentions the Iron Sheik, and then it's over. 2:02 to go. Might even be a Nature Boy Ric Flair impression down there. That was in honor of you, Mr. Haggerty. If you're watching this and you know Mr. Haggerty, tell him to go watch that broadcast. Just that little bit, the Corey Bethany Ric Flair tribute. Now 2 minutes to go. 15-point deficit for the Spartans. Here's Shepard, the top scorer for him. And he's putting a couple away here. Orff now into the game. Orff into the game. Looks like Matt Buskey out there. Ari Jackson. Davis Oftenbrink. Josh Nunn. Young lineup out there right now for the Cadets to kill this one off. Nunn, little surprised he still had the ball, but they're going to get, looks like, Walls on the foul. And that is his first foul. So a minute and a half to go. Nunn at the line. Puts the first one away, draws some applause from his teammates. And he gets another one. Lee Richmond's going to check into the game for Sam Orff. I'd imagine his job is done tonight.
Well, I think they was expecting him to play more, but Coach RJ was trying to bark off some instructions, and he was down in front of the Hazelwood East bench for whatever reason.
A little miscommunication. And here's Shepard, draws another foul. Shepard quietly working his way back into this game, up to 14 points.
Yeah, he's trying to turn it on, yeah.
Again, a little too late. 14-point lead. Player who averages, was it 21? And Manley can't get it to go. No one's going to go out. I think Lee Richmond tipped it, so it will be Spartan ball. Corey Shepard, 21.2 per game. .101 field goals made going into this game. 297 points. And Richmond ends up with it as we tick inside of a minute. Looking likely now that the Cadets will advance to play the winner of St. Louis Christian and Cardinal Ritter in Friday night's final. We will be bringing you that game here on the Cadets Student Network. It'll be at 8 o'clock Friday night. Very much looking forward to it. And Richmond getting yelled at to shoot it. I don't think by the coaches. 22 seconds. Gets inside. CBC just dribbling around trying to kill this one off right now. No fouls from the Spartans. Now Josh Nunn is inside of 10 seconds. Five. And that is going to do it as we get the final buzzer now. And it's in the books. A 14-point win for the Cadets tonight. What did it for him, Corey?
Hazelwood East was kind of outmatched. I mean, inside, outside guard play. They just couldn't match the intensity of CBC defense. You know, the full court press, and Corey Shepard couldn't get going. He couldn't get it going. So
until too late, he did get it going at the end. But
he got 14, but definitely not enough.
And is that CBC at their best? Did we just see CBC at their highest gear?
No, I can see more. I mean, you know, you didn't. Everyone contributed. You know, but you still allowed 60 points. So that's just a little high for being so dominant. You know, I'm sure you always, as a coach, you always looking ways to get better, and I think they always looking to get better and trying to improve.
So we'll look to see how that goes on Friday. But last thing we do, of course, in the broadcast is pick our MVP. So who is your player of the game, Mr. Bethany?
I don't know. It's a tough one. Who do you think?
Well, you could give it to Ketchings for the dominance you showed earlier. You could give it to Willis. You could give it to Clark. You could give it to Barnes. There's four guys you could give it to.
I know, right?
I think it's a complete team performance. I hate to do the commentator cop-out, but I really think you got to give it just to the CBC squad. I think it's a complete win, and it's a team win. So rather than try to arbitrarily pick somebody out of the crowd, we'll let you do that if you want. But, you know, give it to Clark for the alley-oop. I don't care. But all said and done, it is CBC advancing to the final. That's going to do it for us here on CSN. For all the students who made this broadcast possible, Charlie Hines, John Rolfe, Will Kratz, Mr. Randy Gardner, and for all of us here on CSN, we are Corey Bethany and Tom Eichwald. We will see you on Friday for the championship. Good night, everybody.